$5.
That's badass. Thank
same
you.
Same guy. $7.
What's his name? Give him a shout out.
Junior Johnson.
Thank you, Junior Johnson.
Yeah, bro, I'm saving myself to marriage.
That's B-Fly's line. And I need a security check on that line.
Fuck him.
Hey, what do you think about B-Fly? Potential of being very famous?
He's got the charisma.
No, I don't want to burn.
He's got the character. He's got the flash. He's got the attitude.
He has some boxing skills, too.
He's got skills, so.
Can Victor help him move up to 35?
Yeah.
So he and Ryan Garcia.
Got you with the right team, the right training. You know, he could grow a little bit more, you know.
So you guys are going to promote him, right, Garcia? Because there's a lot of promoters interested. So I told him, just take a step back. He's okay now.
Mike had a private conversation.
How you doing, Victor?
It's fun. We do it again and again. Mr. Ellie, how are you?
Reporting.
Don't mean to mess up your...
come on. I gotta ask you a question really quick. There's a guy in a gym. He has to be one of the most popular fighters on the planet right now. His name is B-Fly.
B-Fly.
Are you familiar with him?
No, I know A-Fly.
No, he's B-Fly.
He's our guy.
He's their guy, but he's crazy popular.
Okay.
Like, really, he has a rock star status.
Is he, and he trains with Robert?
Yeah.
He's 3-0.
We have a picture that we're posting today. Watch, I'll show you
right now. Robert sent him some pictures that I sent to you, too. Is he one of those three?
This kid. Little white kid. That kid.
That's him.
That's
yeah.
him, yeah.
So he weighs 115.
Hey, when he's not here, we're talking about B-Fly.
Turn it around here. What do I mean, do I know who B-Fly is? You see what's on his chest?
It's SNAC.
He's part of SNAC Nation.
Okay,
baby.
Can you help him
he's
move?
He's following the king of boxing.
Okay,
here.
Can you help him jump? How many weight classes is from 15 to 35?
We gotta move up a couple weight classes.
18, 20. He's 15. So can you help him move up 7 weight classes to fight Ryan Garcia?
Listen, here's what I've learned from Mikey, okay? It's about a number of factors, but the most important factor is right here. It's right there. Okay.
So, can you help B-Fly? 135, Ryan Garcia, 135. What do you think? Good fight?
Good fight.
I think he probably whoops Ryan's butt myself.
Do you like that fight, Peter? If Victor can help B-Fly move up?
I got you up to like $30 right now.
All right, lunch is on me.
Oh,
my gosh.
So, Victor, tell me about having Mikey here for the first time in your gym.
Well,
he's looking very, very solid. He's looking strong.
Of course, I don't know. What do you want me to sit down over here? I got a bad back. So
okay, no problem.
Sit somewhere. Does this work?
Yeah.
Hey, but you're right under the heater.
Yeah.
The other day he was right here. He's like, fuck, I'm getting a tan here.
Huh? We'll go over here.
So Mikey's been for 1 month at your gym. Mm-hmm. Mikey, one of the best pound-for-pound, if not the best pound-for-pound fighter on the planet.
Yes.
He's jumping up 2 weight classes to fight the most avoided fighter in boxing, and Errol Spence. How has this month been with Mikey here?
Phenomenal. He's a genetically gifted guy. We see it and have seen it for a while in his blood work. The smartest thing he ever did is pick the right mom and dad.
Well, you don't pick your parents, but...
How do you know?
Well, in this day and age, anything's possible because they could pick. They could design a baby with the eyes, the set, everything in labs now.
Listen. As you know, we've had a history here, and a lot of world class fighters have come through.
I saw John Elway's thing jersey here.
Well, how about Dan Marino? How about I could go on and on and on about that? We've had back to back Super Bowl champion Denver Broncos, so. Yeah, there's a very long history of excellence associated with SNAC. But Mikey is a special fighter. So, you know, whatever limitations that there may be for most, I don't think those exist for him. So dream big, live large, you know, dare to be great. That's Mikey Garcia.
If you had to recommend him which Bentley to buy, because Mikey's a big car guy, what Bentley would you recommend?
Well, he likes speed, so probably the Continental GT, the new one they came out with. It's got a W12 and goes over 200 miles an hour. He's a speed demon, so I'd say probably that one.
And Victor's a Bentley
he's
guy.
More,
so.
You're more of a coupe guy than a flying spur guy.
So you gonna get it?
I got something coming in.
He's already. No, he's a step above that. He's
Lambo.
He's Lambo man. I'm waiting.
They're
to
asking.
See that
they're
one.
Asking what was it that you saw that was special, Mikey's blood work. Anything specific?
Oh, I'll tell you specifically. first of all, his you measure there's something called the globular filtration rate, and that is basically how quick when you inhale. that your system can transport nutrients and oxygen, let's say to your quads, and then it's a two-way street. The way it works is it delivers the nutrients and oxygen. Imagine they're little dump trucks. And then it loads up with all of the metabolic waste byproducts, lactic acid, ammonia, carbon dioxide, etc. Then it comes back up, and then you exhale, right? So we measure that, the globular filtration rate, and we pulled out, I don't want to name names here to give, you know, the medical data of other fighters, but other top welterweights, one of who is a current world champion, as an example, and you want to be over 59, right? You get less than that, and you've got poor circulation. I think the two that we like pulled up, or three, were like 72 and 78, and I think Mikey was 123.
Wow.
So he's on another planet.
Didn't I tell you that today when I walked in and you said, how do you know?
Yeah.
I know my stuff, huh? I was right. I didn't know the numbers.
Yeah.
Let me ask you really quick, way off the subject. I'm good friends with John Jones. He tested right now and he said he passed. He's clean in the test that they did after his fight. As an expert, what did you make of what happened with him?
Okay. First of all, way back in 2015 when he first tested positive, it was highly suspicious. Now, the reason is because his testosterone level is suppressed to zero. So when you take exogenous testosterone, creams, gels, injections, whatever it may be, so that saturates your receptors or your cups on your muscle tissue, and it shuts your system down so your body's not producing any. So that was highly suspicious, okay? So I've always been suspicious, and I've heard all sorts of stories of the doping control officers coming and him hiding under the octagon and in Arizona and all this. So I've had a high degree of suspicion. However, most recently, with this oral turenabol test and all the scientific studies that have been done in terms of can this lodge in adipose or fat tissue in your body and stay there for a long period of time, and of course now they're talking about July of whatever it was, 17 until now, so it has been some 15 months, but there are other anabolic steroids, specifically one called nandrolone, that there was a case as far back as 1981, a discus thrower named Ben Plunknett, and he tested positive. And then, of course, they give you a sanction and you have to sit out, but in the meantime, they test you so you can get reinstated. 18 months later, he was still positive. So can it hang around? You look, there are references. The longest lasting steroid in terms of clearance is nandrolone. The second longest is turenabol. So is it possible that there were still small, ultra trace amounts, and they talk about picograms, which is parts per trillion in lay terms. So could it be possible that it was still there? And the answer is yes. So I'm coming down, believe it or not, because I don't agree much with Dana White or Nowitzki or others that are part of the UFC camp. But in this specific case, I'm a true speaker, so I think that it was probably still there from 15 months ago and was not from a re-ingestion of the same substance more recently.
But why the beef with Dana White and, what was it, Karl Nowitzki, what's his name?
Who?
Nowitzki?
Oh, Jeff Nowitzki.